Now, what you can do is you can then name that marker or rename it. Just double click here and the box will show up and you can now then edit that and just say, I'll just say new marker. Press return and it will give you the new marker name. Okay. Now you can also do the same thing here within the marker pane. If you double click on that, you can get down to this part of the screen and just say, or just type in the new name right there. So a couple of different places you can do that. Again, either just double clicking directly on the marker or double clicking within this pane right here. The other thing that you can do, and also just to delete that, you just click it and then just press the delete key and it'll go. Now, the other use of markers is for navigation. If you press the if you use the control key in combination with both the comma and the period key, that'll navigate the playhead to each marker based on what it is. So right now I'm going to press the control period key, and as you can see, the playhead is skipping through to each marker as I click that key. So this is a pretty cool way of just navigating quickly through. If I press control and comma, it'll backspace in markers. So the way to think about it is forward it will be control period, and then backwards is control comma. And you can use that in conjunction with actually playing the track back. So if I play this, and then I use the control period key, you can see it skipping through to the different marker sections. And here's control comma, which will go backwards. So that's a pretty cool way of navigating through the markers and finding out exactly what they are. Now there's another neat way of playing back the markers that I don't think is very well known. But go over to the marker pane here and select the finger tool. I'm using my left click, so I'm gonna choose that. So let me go finger tool right here, and then if you take that finger tool and you click and hold on the marker name, it'll start playing through that marker. So it'll play as long as I'm holding it. So if I just release, it'll stop. And then if I go to Wah Guitar right here, let me click on that. Here's brass. And I don't know if it shows up in the screen here, but there's a little white line that's really like a horizontal playhead marker that's playing down through the marker itself. That is that's really the elements of how you actually play through. Now, to make it a little more readable, the other thing we can do is we can actually change the color of these markers. And the way you do that is in the view section right here, just click on view, go down to color, and you can select a color. I'm just going to select a green here that just says we're starting, and let me just go into this guy. So that changed to green, and let's leave the verse at black. I don't know if that shows up too well on the screen, so you know what, I'm going to make that a bit more vibrant green. There you go, now that's blinding. So if we skip over to brass, we just select the marker there, and let's make that one yellow. And now that marker's yellow, and we could change piano to white if we had to. Or actually, that's just going to do the reverse when I'm black there. Let's just leave it. And then Wah Guitar, if we wanted to make that red, let's just select a red color. And And you can simply go through that and change each one of them, whatever way you want. So you can create markers according to the color that you want, just to help you navigate through. The other thing you can do is you can make them look a little bit different. You can choose the font size down here. Just click on font, and it will bring up the font, and you can change the actual font also. That, for all intents and purposes, shows you how to create markers, how to edit them, how to move them, and how to do coloring. So what we would do at this point in time is we would just bounce the file down. So I would just bounce this track, and when I bounced it, it would embed those markers within the bounced track. So in the next section, we're going to take a look at how to use that bounced track with markers within MainStage, and then use the markers to navigate through.